My name is Joan Han, and I'm a pediatric endocrinologist. I did my training here at the NIH for pediatric endocrinology, and then I stayed afterwards to continue my research career. Our focus is studying rare genetic disorders that are associated with obesity and neurocognitive dysfunction to try to understand different neuroendocrine factors that influence this. So when I was looking at different endocrinology programs to do training, the thing that I wanted most was an opportunity to do clinical research as well as basic science research, because I wanted to combine the two. And so the idea of having a bench and bedside focus was really important to me. Studying rare genetic disorders here, we can bring patients from all around the world. In addition to Wagner syndrome, which is caused by chromosome 11 deletions, we also study isolated mutations within genes on chromosome 11, including PAX6. And we also study Prader-Willi syndrome, which causes cognitive impairment and hyperphagia. Most of the patients who come to the NIH with these rare genetic disorders have serious health problems and significant complications from their condition. And what's interesting is actually James is the opposite. He's actually probably the least affected of all the patients we've seen so far. And so I think one of the questions he asked was, well, you know, since I don't have problems, like I don't know if I'm even worth studying. And I explained to him that it's actually what sets him apart from the other patients may very well hold the clue or the key to be able to find treatments for all the other patients who carry the same genetic change that he has, but somehow they seem to have a worse outcome. So maybe he has other genetic or environmental factors that are making a difference in his health that we might be able to apply and improve the health of other patients. From my perspective, every patient who comes here is so generous to give of their time, particularly when the patient's a child, for their parents to bring their child here to participate in research studies. I consider that such an incredible, generous sacrifice on their part. And what amazes me every time is at the end of the visit, the families say thank you to us. And I don't even feel that, it's me that this should be grateful to them. Every one of these families has been a vital part of our research, and without them it would be impossible for us to learn about these rare diseases.